Hi. Oh my god, there is just so much to tell you. Wow. Where do I start? We got hit with a new computer bug this week? Fantastic. Yeah. The iPhone bends now. Yeah, let's figure that one out together. There's probably going to be a new Facebook-like platform, which for some reason depresses me. I don't mean to sound like a bummer. There's plenty of what the tech to talk about, which pretty much makes up for anything negative out there because everyone needs to laugh. Laughing is good for you. It's September 26th, and welcome to the Red Headed Geek Show. What's the opposite of last but not least? So, if you haven't heard of Ello, well, just thank me for being here to tell you about it, I guess. Ello is an ad-free, invite-only, independent social media network. Think of a low-budget indie movie that probably turns out to be a cult classic. I don't know, I have no idea if Ello is going to steer folks away from Facebook, but if it does, it's because it's gaining this sort of anti-Facebook reputation. It's also gaining popularity in the LGBT crowd, especially after Facebook decided it wanted to lock out a whole bunch of drag performers from their accounts. Yeah, let's face it, Facebook is anti-drag queen. And that just pisses me off. It's none of anyone's business what their lifestyle is like. I'm not getting in a cranky mood right now. Back to the point. Ello hopes to be a tool for empowerment, not to, quote, deceive, coerce, and manipulate. And those sound like really good intentions, sure. But people contribute to those negative aspects of Facebook, not just Facebook alone, right? If you notice, I never talk about Twitter. I've never had a Twitter account, therefore I don't feel the need to analyze it. Whereas with Facebook, I use it and understand why everyone complains about it all the time. Side note. And now it's time for my segment dedicated to the weird, crazy, and stupid. Here is... So, this iPhone bend thing, let's talk about it. It bends? I guess too many people trusted their new iPhone 6s enough to squeeze them into those skinny jeans. Because, well, apparently they start to bend after in a pocket for an extended period of time. Several hours, actually. This is really making me wonder just how tight those people's pants were. It's being called #bendgate. I don't know either, but there's only 9 or so cases of this incredibly bendy iPhone. Why must we seriously make a hashtag for something that isn't exactly an epidemic? Dramatic much, America? The new Cash smartwatch will tell you when you're spending too much money. Going to Starbucks twice a day? Every day? Shoe addict? Cash smartwatch, maybe for you. Or, you know, you could also just gain some self-control and stop impulse buying because you're gonna go broke. Anybody else lose their marbles when you drop your smartphone? Like, it's the end of the frickin' world. I feel like I've dropped something alive, something with a heartbeat. And once it hits the ground, I'm always like, oh, this is it.
Oh, my mom.
I start planning how I'm gonna get the money. Like, okay, Monday, I'll go give blood if they pay for that. Tuesday, I'll sell all my clothes, and Wednesday, I'll rob a bank because I need my phone. So of course, the phone isn't broken. I just freak out. It never is. iPhones like to break slowly and sneakily, like dead battery or something. So, to add to the horrible trauma of dropping your smartphone, how about a new jailbreak that will make your phone scream as it's being dropped? This is my new favorite thing. I know we love our wearables. Smartwatches are cool, yeah. But what about making the world a better place? Does anyone ever think of that? I'm sure you do. You're nice people. How about a wearable artificial kidney? No vanity here, huh? This comes after the project started back in 2008. The wearable kidney hopes to make the dialysis process better for patients. Hospitals suck. and they're also boring. So this device is a good alternative. It weighs 10 pounds, is attached around the person's waist, and allows the patient to be mobile while being treated. Finally, what better way to celebrate the Colonel's birthday than this totally practical chicken leg iPhone case? KFC Japan is whack, folks. Whack. Whew, fun stuff. Not so fun is the new attack on our computers. We just recovered from the scare of the heartbleed bug, and now the new vulnerability is called Shellshock or Bash bug, which is affecting Linux and Mac computers. What does it mean? The hackers can basically get inside of your computer and control it and your servers, which means yes, it can gain access to your personal information. Don't think you're in the clear because, oh, I just use Windows or something. Because if you realized how many servers and web-connected devices and things use Linux, this would scare you. Sorry, not to scare you. Well, no. Yeah, you should be scared. Bash bug is harder to detect and measure than the heartbleed, which is leading security experts to believe that this could last a lot longer and affect more people than heartbleed, which hit around 500,000 back in April. And you can't just go and change some passwords and feel safe. The patches we are waiting for are coming, but we have to sit tight and try to remain up to date. That's what the internet told me. I always feel so much better when I get all of that off my chest. I hope you learned something, or if you didn't, maybe you laughed a little, cried, overall enjoyed my performance. Thank you so much for watching. Stay up to date on the Red Headed Geek Show by subscribing to Parts-People.com. That's where I live. You will find me here every Friday. It's really awkward. I never know how to walk off. I'm just gonna walk off. The book of 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 the book of